So this morning I'm making healthy pancakes. Fuck me dead. What shaving does. I'm making healthy pancakes from bananas. I know I made pancakes the other day, and that was like a tasty mixture. This is very, I reckon this is tastier, but it's a healthy one. I'm gonna get started. It's 5:30 in the morning. I've been jogging for an hour, so. My mise en place. You're saying it's an electric stove top, so I'm gonna turn it on now, get it ready. Nearly done, my mise en place. Bananas. Two bananas. This will make a lot of pancakes, about four or five, which will last a couple of hours for me. Now, I don't have a masher, but I'm going to improvise because I have got this lemon thing. That's what cooking is all about, improvising. So I'll see if this works. Nah, fuck no. Put it this. Nah, that's not going to work. It sort of works. Gets it squished. But it doesn't go through the holes. I want it squished and then I can keep squishing it until it's runny. Bananas that are soft are the best for this. Not off, but soft. You don't want to do this with raw bananas. It doesn't work well. You can do it, but it's better when it's yellow. Full yellow. I'm going to try and improvise. I'm going to use this as the bottom of this plate as a mortar. Two bananas, large bananas. Well, one was really large, the other one was large.
work as a pancake mixture. And then I'm going to sift flour into it. And I've got to butter the pan. You don't have to butter the pan, you can oil it. It's not butter pancakes, but I think actually I'm going to use butter because I want the buttery taste. I want it crisp with a buttery taste. You're not to use much butter, so it's still healthy. You're only buttering the pan, but you just want those, that, not residue or remnants, but just that lingering buttery taste on the crisp. Oh, I love doing this. Sort of like whipping chantilly cream. Or emulsifying fucking mayonnaise or whatever. But you're not just scrambling the banana until it's fully mushy and almost liquid. You can do this in a blender, but then it becomes too, it becomes too liquidy. And this naturally starts to liquefy in its own juices or whatever it is. It's weird. It's very similar to, you can make baby food like this. It's already at the consistency of baby food. So if you were gonna make baby food, you might do this to a mango. Some other stuff. Maybe put a little bit of egg, depending how old the baby is. And you've got yourself a very healthy and cheap form of baby food. That's all you do. You just, it's so much cheaper than buying baby food and so much healthier. You just get bananas and do this. And you put it, I don't know how tolerant, I forgot the levels of tolerance for kids and protein, babies. You get the point. The whole point, the point is, this is how you do the pancake. Get it to that baby mixture. Good enough. You might still see some wavy consistency, but as long as they're not full lumps, it's okay. You don't want it to be watery. The whole point is to get a very mushy and tasty pancake. You can even taste the banana in the pancake. That's how I like it. So that's good enough already.
Perfect.
Now I can sift some flour into it. Approximately a cup, I think. I'll know by the consistency. I just have that eye. So I've got about a cup in there now. And I'll sift it in there. You don't want lumpy fucking flour in there. Yuck. Yeah, that pan is definitely heating. Now that's mixing. It's perfect. It's clumping. Now you can use low-fat milk. You can use full cream milk, special milk, almond milk, whatever the fuck you like. I like to use full cream milk. I like it to have it straight from the cow, unmolested. You just want, at this point, you just want to water it down till it gets to the right pancake consistency. This is where the consistency comes in. This is now becoming a pancake. Just before it becomes fully consistent, I'm going to introduce an egg into it to bind it. I don't want to introduce the egg into it when it's the right consistency. See, it's now becoming pancakey. That's a lot of pancake mixture. That'll probably last me till tomorrow. Heat down on the pan because it is a lot. You only need one egg. You do need to whisk it. Skip with a spoon because that's all I've got. Forks are fine. Forks work really well. I reckon forks are better than actually using a whisk sometimes. Most of the time. Depending how much you've got. This works. Well, you know what you're doing and you know how to improvise, it'll work. But nothing ever matches proper equipment, does it? That's fine. Egg in. Now this should make it even runnier again. And then I can start to fine tune how liquidy it needs to be, the consistency. And that's what the milk does. You don't have to use plain flour. I just love the plain flour taste. It's still healthy, but if you want it to be super healthy, that's when you can use the whole wheat flour and all the other shit. Similar effect, just not as tasty. And I've got no intolerances or anything like that. I've got no intolerances, allergies, etc. So it's all good for me. Obviously, if you do, that's when you may need to have the wholemeal stuff, etc. But there's a product for everybody. So even if you do have an intolerance or allergy, there's always a product for you if you look carefully enough, even in the shelves at Woolies. See, it's starting to become pancakey consistency. It needs to be a little bit more watered down. Until it really becomes a pancake mixture. A crepe mixture is almost water. Not water, but a pancake still needs to have some sort of thickness. It's getting there. I needed a bigger bowl. Fuck. It would have worked even better. But yeah, I can still get it right. Bowl's not going to overflow. Yep, pancake. This should be enough. Whilst I get that right, about a teaspoon of sugar. I'm using whatever the fuck sugar this is. You can, I would use just normal brown sugar. But this looks like exciting sugar. Whatever the fuck it is. Tastes alright. About half a tablespoon. Just to have that sweetness. Even though you've got it in the banana. But nothing wrong with a little bit of sugar. Just don't go overboard. Half a teaspoon is fine. Obviously, you can omit the sugar. You don't have to have it in there. But again, my body is very versatile and adaptive. And it doesn't have problems when with small amounts of this, small amounts of that. Me being over... I'm not overweight, but a little bit on the chubby side, mind you, is just how I am. But like, it doesn't take long for me to get very super fit on what I'm actually eating now. Hence, this for me is my health food. Yeah, that's perfect consistency. So now I'm going to get the butter, and it's ready to make pancakes. I just want to lube the pan. This is not to put in there, it's just to lube the pan. And you'll get a bit of that buttery aftertaste anyway, as I said before, on the crisp. Show you where it's at now. That's perfect. See how liquidy it is? Banana. Banana pancakes. Oops. What the fuck's this thing doing? Oh. Oh, that tastes good. Even, I could drink that. You've got to be careful when you cook it because the banana makes it not runny but a bit loose, so you've just got to be very careful. That's definitely enough mixture for today and tomorrow. Jesus. So while that gets ready, I'm gonna cut a few macadamia nuts. make it coarser. Not too fine, just coarse. Like coarser. You don't want whole peanuts in your mouth. That's perfect. Perfect pancake. Wow. That thing's gonna fucking melt in my mouth. I'm gonna put about 3 strawberries. I'm gonna make that 4. This is a small. Just quartered, don't have to have them fancy. Done. Oh, that's the best one I've ever made. So that was the other side. That's perfect. That's just before it gets starts to burn. But it's not even close to burn. It's just perfect. Yeah, a little bit more. And because it's banana, it's not always going to conform perfectly round. But as you can see, it's, oh, that's perfect. Oh, wow. That's a fucking perfect pancake. Oh, my God. Now, you can make them fluffy, and you do that by getting particular small pans and thickening it. But they're not proper pancakes. This is a proper pancake, which is, again, thicker than the crepe. That's the proper way to call it. A pancake is thicker than the crepe. Yeah, it's ready. So I'll just put this down.
I flipped it. I'm even going to cook the other side that I already cooked a little bit longer because it's. I want it a bit more brown.
Wiping fucking plates with my underpants.
That's fucking hilarious. One will do for now, and the way I'm going to present this, it's very simple. Strawberries in the middle, nuts around.
Was honey and honey over. You can use golden syrup, whatever you like, but I like honey, always honey.
So that's it.
taste test still. Again, you could roll this, but I don't like that. Let me give you an honest appraisal. Let's see if it's better than anything I've made before. Oh my God.
Oh my God. 10 out of 10. Oh my God. Oh my God, that is so nice. Banana pancake. It's like a full banana. The honey and the nuts and the strawberry. Oh my God, that is so nice. Oh wow. That's shockingly nice. And the most amazing thing of all, it's healthy. I mean, you can make a few adjustments to make it even healthier, but I'm not, you know, intolerant of anything and allergic to anything. And this isn't a good, for my body size, 130 kilos is like just a little chubby for me. 110 kilos is almost anorexic. 100 kilos. So this is a perfect portion for me when I'm in my fitness mode. Oh my God. That's so fucking delicious, it's not funny. And if you want to be a bit more peculiar with your nutrition needs in terms of protein intake, you can mix a little bit, you can mix one cup of protein in there, but you'd have to minus a little bit of flour, and you might need to put one more egg. It's just a little bit of fine tuning, that's all it is. It's, you shouldn't find it daunting, that's all it is. But with me, I don't need protein. At all. Well, I do, but I don't need a higher protein intake. My body just churns it. Whatever it puts for, whatever I eat is enough in the day. Fish and meat. It just uses all of it, and hence all the muscle. So I don't need to be that pedantic. But if you did want to pack on the muscle strategically, you'd put a cup in there of chocolate protein, whatever the fuck you like. I'd use vanilla protein for this. Otherwise, we'll have conflicting tastes. The vanilla protein will work really well with the banana. Oh my God. I mean, when do I ever eat a complete meal in front of people? This. I don't know what the fuck I just made. Wow. In terms of banana pancake, 10 out of 10. Best pancake I've ever had. Fucking wow. Oh God. The strawberries, the nuts, the honey, the pancake, the, oh wow. So tempted to make another one and another one, but I'm in my strict, must be super fit mode, and I've got to be disciplined to do that. I'm already jogging an hour a morning, and I've been doing that for ages now, a couple of months. This bout of the coronavirus sent me back for 1 or 2 weeks, but my immune system seems to have absolutely annihilated the coronavirus. I've already fully recovered. It's after like a week or two. Oh, that looks good. Oh my god. That was epic. Oh my god. I'm amazed. Oh my god.
The perfect pancake.